Hello and welcome to a video about solubility and saturation. So what we're going to look at today is solubility and the solubility curve, saturation 3, equilibrium and saturated solution, 4, solubility curves revisited, 5, saturation versus supersaturation, and 6, gas solubility and its significance. Water is a solvent, and water is usually the solvent that people are interested in because of water's ability to dissolve a huge variety of compounds, and that includes all of the reactants that react in living organisms to produce very valuable products. A solute is the compound that gets dissolved. A salt crystal large enough to see with your own eyes would have greater than 10 to the 22 ions in it. So that is what this is representing. And when we put it in the water, it splits apart. They dissociate. And here we have a solution composed of water and the dissolved particles. Solubility is the maximum amount of solute that can dissolve, and we will go into much more detail shortly. Solubility curves give us maximum amounts that can dissolve, and we will explore that intimately starting now. Let's just look at one of these curves for now, that of sodium acetate. And let's see what sort of information this curve gives us. So we call this the solubility curve or the solubility line. And that shows the maximum solute that can be dissolved per 100 grams of H2O, which is what we put on the y-axis. But that maximum is per some specific temperature. So at any given temperature, you have a specific amount that you can dissolve, and that amount increases as the temperature increases. So for example, if we had the maximum amount dissolved at 40 degrees Celsius, the amount that can dissolve is simply read on the y-axis. So 93 grams is the solubility of this substance at 40 degrees Celsius. 93 grams is the maximum that can be dissolved at 40 degrees Celsius. The term saturation tells us that the maximum amount of solute is dissolved. So in these conditions, 93 grams saturates 100 grams of water at 40 degrees Celsius. The term solubility, however, is more specific. It is quantitative. Solubility is the maximum mass of solute that can be dissolved per given mass of water at a given temperature. So any condition of concentration and temperature below the line is considered unsaturated. Less than the maximum solute is dissolved. Any condition of concentration and temperature above the line is saturated. So what's the difference between that and being on the line? Let's take a look. So let's say you're at room temperature and unsaturated. Where on the graph would you be? Well, about 22 or 23 degrees is room temperature, and we're going to be below the solubility line. So we'll put our point right there. That's room temperature and unsaturated. Now we're going to assume that adding this amount will result in maximum dissolved solute. Where on the graph would we be? What do you think? Let's take a look. So here we are now. If we drop this in and it dissolves, we are now at the maximum amount that can be dissolved. So we are now on the solubility curve. We are both at solubility and saturation. So we can use the graph to see the amount added to saturate the solution. What's going to happen if we add even more solute? Let's take a look. It does not appear to dissolve. And I say the word appear very specifically. We will explore that very soon. So what you would see visually is undissolved solute sitting at the bottom. And as we know, we can't actually see those individual particles that are dissolved, and so the solution looks clear. And so the graph tells us the amount that remains as a solid. But what's really going on here? Let's go back to the solubility curve and drop that same amount in again. So what happens is that actually does dissolve. The particles in that solid continually go into solution, while particles in solution continually join the crystal. It keeps going back and forth, but the amount, the total amount of solid, remains virtually constant. So on a macro scale, we actually don't see any change in the solid that is there. So if you see solid sitting at the bottom of a solution, then the solution is saturated and it is in equilibrium with the solid. What does that mean? The amount of solid that dissolves into solution is equal to the amount of dissolved particles that join the crystal. That is our equilibrium. So the difference between being saturated on the solubility line is that there's no equilibrium. There's no visible solid. Everything is dissolved. But if you go above the solubility line, you're still saturated, but now you have solid that is in equilibrium with the solution. Solid particles continually dissolving while dissolved particles continually recrystallize. So let's look at something interesting. Solubility is dependent on temperature. Let's see what happens to that solid as we heat up the solution. Yes, it dissolves, it breaks apart. Let's watch it again closely. Right as the blue dot crosses the solubility line, the last of the particles break up. So we are now unsaturated. We have heated it up where we can actually add more solute to the solvent and have them dissolve. What's really interesting about this, that brown area, the condition of concentration and temperature above the solubility line, can also be something called supersaturated. It can be supersaturated under specific conditions. We just cool it down carefully and do not provide a small crystal face for the dissolved particles to start crystallizing onto. The particles will stay in solution unless they have a crystalline face to join and become solid. So here's an unsaturated solution of sodium acetate, and the blue dot tells us where we are on the solubility graph. And then this was cooled down, but now the solute above maximum remains dissolved. So now we're looking at a supersaturated solution. It looks the same. We don't see any difference. So what we're going to do now is drop in a couple of seed crystals. In other words, tiny crystals that provide a little face for those particles above solubility to grab onto and start to form a solid. And as you can see, those particles on the graph are coming out of solution and becoming a solid. And the graph tells us how much is actually crystallized out of solution. The energy changes that take place here are very interesting when looked at from the perspective of changing potential and kinetic energies. In the cool-down solution at room temperature, the solute above solubility should solidify and get to a more favorable position, the crystalline form, which is a lower potential energy, which is the direction that nature is pushing it. However, it needs a path to get to that lower potential energy, which in this case is provided for by a small seed crystal dropped into the supersaturated solution. The path to crystallization, lower potential energy. But where did that lost potential energy go? Law of conservation of energy, it went to kinetic energy. The particles solidifying increased their kinetic energy, which means an increase in temperature. The solidifying sodium acetate gets quite warm. Okay, so we've been talking about sodium acetate here, but there's lots and lots of other compounds that will dissolve in water, and they all have positive slopes. And this is what we would normally see in the graphs of solubilities of solids in water. But what about gases? Gases have negative slopes. As you increase temperature, gases become less soluble. And in particular, the fact that that happens with oxygen has great consequences for life in water. You can see here the different temperatures that occur at the ocean surface. What happens to the availability of oxygen in the very cold water versus warmer water? As the water gets warmer, the availability of oxygen decreases. So where life thrives in the ocean is a compromise between temperature and oxygen availability. So the warmest water, that the bright red, has less diversity of life than if you go a bit further north or south,
or go to a greater depth of 100 to 200 meters,
where temperatures are cooler, but there's more oxygen available. I'm going to go back. I want you to take a look at the carbon dioxide line at the bottom. So carbon dioxide is not very soluble, and the solubility actually doesn't change much. And this has a lot to do with ocean acidification. which we will get to a bit later. And this has been a Mad Scientist production. See ya.